So it's off to the magnificent Spa circuit for round 13 of the 2010 FF1M season. A recap of the last season's race with Jenson Button winning ahead of the two shake and bakes, Hamilton and Glock. Christian Kleen took pole position in that race. That's a name that we've forgotten now. Only FF1M racing this weekend, no FF2M or FF3M. Long circuit, 7 kilometres long, 44 laps, featuring some of the most spectacular corners such as Eau Rouge, Puan and the Blanchimont. Those are just some of the fast ones. And taking pole position by a fairly enormous 0.8 of a second is Nico Hülkenberg in the Mitchell, one of the fastest men of the season. At the moment, he's ahead of another German, Vettel, and Raikkonen third, ahead of Hamilton fourth. That's good for Hamilton's championship prospects. He's currently 20 points ahead of Alonso. Buemi not too far behind. Speaking of the man, he's starting fifth, ahead of Mark Webber in the LeBlanc, the very, very fragile LeBlanc. Completing the top 10, Sutil, Kobayashi, Grosjean and Trulli. So ready for the start, and it's go. And difficult to see what's happening from this camera angle, but Hülkenberg looks as if he's got away well, but outbreaking him into Lesource is Raikkonen in the tornado, taking the lead. He's going down Lesource into Eau Rouge. And there's contact there. There's contact between one of the Mitchells and what looked like an Andy Racing. I think it was Piquet. They saw an Andy Racing get airborne briefly. That was Barrichello in last. But in first is Raikkonen. Vettel is second. Buemi has made up positions to third. Hülkenberg down to fifth. So awful start for the German. Dropping four positions from his pole position grid slot. I think that's pretty much what McNish did in the 98 race. Although it was Verstappen who started fifth and then leading. So Hülkenberg's done the opposite of what Verstappen did there for FJR. And Vettel coming under a little bit of pressure from Buemi. Mitchell, I would say, does have the fastest car. Certainly not from the first half of the season. But definitely as the season's coming along, they're looking a lot stronger now. And that was Hülkenberg challenging Lewis Hamilton at La Fania. Into Stavelot, Hamilton trying to hang on, and he looks as if he is doing so. And he's holding on to fourth place. If he stays there, he would extend his lead from Alonso. Speaking of which, he started way down in 11th and hasn't made much progress so far. This is Buemi versus Vettel into bus stop, the second position, and Buemi has got it. What is happening here? And Hamilton was nudged by Kobayashi, and he's off the track, and he shunts an FJR out of the way very rudely. That was Grosjean that he pushed, and Grosjean nearly making a mess of the second half of the bus stop. So Hamilton being nudged by Kobayashi, and then Hamilton rejoining the circuit, did not know that Grosjean was there and just drove him off. Now then into lap two, into Eau Rouge, and there is Alonso behind Sutil. Sutil in eighth place. He has in fact dropped a position from his grid slot of 7th. Hamilton down to 7th now. Webber up to 5th position now, having got past Kobayashi. That is Alonso losing a position to Piquet. So not going well at the moment for Alonso, even though he's up one position. Piquet started down in 14th, so he's having a good run at the moment, up 5 positions. By the way, just behind Alonso is Trulli. As we look at Buemi, who is 1.5 seconds behind Raikkonen on lap 3. And this is Kobayashi having a look at Mark Webber for 5th place. This is exactly what Hülkenberg tried to do to Hamilton. And Hamilton managed to stay ahead of him. Looks as if Webber is in fact doing the same as Hamilton. So looks as if it's going to be a three-way battle into the bus stop. Let's have a look. Hamilton is the one with the slipstream. Well, he's trying to pull out of it. Now Kobayashi looks as if he's trying to get a run on Webber. Hamilton up the inside. Is there enough space? There is enough space, but not enough momentum to get ahead of the Japanese driver. Can he do it into the start of lap four? Lesource is outbraking him. Very, very late on the brakes, and he manages to take sixth position off the Pedersen driver. So now we can see Hamilton closing up to Mark Webber. Mitchell and Schakenbeck do have the fastest two cars. As Bruno Senna comes into the pits, as we look at Glock versus Chandock, and there's contact between Chandock and the Ghee Racing, and more contact, that is Senna. We saw Senna coming into the pits, that was probably why. That is Sutil slowing down, he's got a problem, and he's out of the race. That's a bit of a shame for him, he qualified quite well, but the race, he has no reliability. So everyone who was behind him has in fact moved position, and saw slowing GRM. That was Hamilton off the road and Stavolo. So getting caught out behind Webber. Webber's got a problem. He's got a problem. Not for the first time this year. It's been horrifically unreliable, has that LeBlanc. In Webber has himself retired from 10 out of 12 races. Senna, not that much better really. 9 out of 12. Even so, LeBlanc are 8th in the championship, ahead of Andy Racing, Shannon and GRM. So, despite reliability problems, shall we say, it's been not a bad debut season for LeBlanc. They took over from Auto Dynamics, who mysteriously went missing before the start of the season. Here's Raikkonen on lap 14, and this looks like pit stop time for Kimi. So making the first out of the serious contenders to make a pit stop. And there's another driver coming into the pits as well. It's Sebastian Buemi. Buemi, 3 wins this season. They came in Brazil, Austria and Silverstone. At the moment he's on 50 points, 32 behind Hamilton. Just going back to LeBlanc's unreliability, if you contrast that with Pedersen, they've only had 2 retirements out of 24 possibilities, so they've been extremely reliable, even if they have had driver changes halfway through. Zaug was replaced by Chandock into the Nürburgring race, but Kobayashi has only had 2 retirements, so very good reliability record for the Pedersen. Back to the action, and there's Buemi chasing Raikkonen. That's for 4th place, but both of those have stopped. I'd expect them to retake the lead. That is Hamilton taking Jenson Button for 6th position. Button having not made a pit stop, Hamilton has. So once again, it looks like fresh tyres seem to be the big, big advantage compared to low fuel. Nico Rosberg taking a position of Jarno Trulli, who has gone backwards. No, it's Kovalainen, sorry. They were battling away for 14th position. Here comes Hülkenberg. It'll be interesting to see where he rejoins. He was running in 4th position before the pit stop started. And here comes Alonso. Needs a good result if he's to stand a chance at the championship. He had a crash in the last race, so not good news for him. He's only had 4 retirements this season. Then again, Hamilton's only had 3. Buemi and Hülkenberg have had 6 each, so the Mitchell's not as reliable as the Tornado or the Schakenbeck. That said, Raikkonen in the other Tornado and Glock in the other Schakenbeck have had 6 retirements each. So, and here's Vettel into the pits. He was running 3rd before the pit stop started. So it'd be crucial to rejoin ahead of Hülkenberg. what has running this extra lap done for the Shannon driver? Looking at Shannon's reliability record, it has been 6 retirements each out of 12 races each for Vettel and Perez, so not stellar, and as a result they're only 10th in the championship. Very surprising when you consider Vettel's strong pace. He rejoins just ahead of Hülkenberg, so, but Hülkenberg's a lot closer. He looks as if he can challenge the German into the next chicane, Lacombe chicane. Jenson Button makes his pit stop. That brings Webber back in, up into the points. Hülkenberg trying it on the brakes. He's got him. That's third place for Hülkenberg, so both Mitchells now in the top three. But Vettel is on one lap younger tyres, so he could still stay quite close. This is the battle for the lead now. Raikkonen only a second ahead of Buemi, and on 27 laps to go. And Hülkenberg and Vettel aren't that far behind either, so the top four are running very, very close. So it's shaping up to be a good finish to the race. There went Hülkenberg through the bus stop, and behind him shortly was Vettel. And the gap was 1 second, it stayed the same. The top four all in the same straight, that's nice to see. But at the moment, it's Kimi Raikkonen in the lead. As they go through the daunting Eau Rouge, seen some pretty bad accidents there in the past, most notably Andy Racing in 2002, where both cars crashed and split in half. Both drivers, Michael Schumacher and Takuma Sato, fortunately okay. To go around Sector 1, Buemi has lost a couple of tenths behind Raikkonen, so Raikkonen looks as if he's got the gap measured. Well, it's not really an accurate split point in the middle of a corner. They're coming up to lap what looks like Perez. It is Perez. Hopefully the Mexican driver won't be too much of a nuisance to Raikkonen. Although, looks as if he is holding him up now as they go through the fan chicane. 18 laps and you're already being lapped at a 7 km circuit. That's quite worrying. And Perez has let Raikkonen through. Is he going to be so generous to Buemi? Sort of, yeah. But it's helped Hülkenberg a lot, because he's now right up behind the other Mitchell driver. Bit of history between those two. They go through the bus stop. Is Perez challenging Hülkenberg, Buemi again? What on earth is he doing? He's just unlapped himself from Buemi. And now Hülkenberg has got the opportunity to have a look at Buemi into La Source. Is he close enough to make a lunge? He's thinking about it. He is. And he's up to second position just about. Yes. Perez caught Buemi out horribly there. And that's going to anger the Swiss driver. Is he going to get held up again as they go going through Eau Rouge? Maybe just a little bit. Now Perez has let the Swiss driver through. Vettel only 3.8 seconds behind Raikkonen, so maybe that was Perez's tactic to help his own teammate Vettel. And still, he, taking a strange line around that corner was Buemi. He was worried Perez was still up on his inside. Didn't make sense. Alonso in sixth position goes through Puon and he's off the track. Is he going to keep all his wheels? He is. Now is he going to rejoin from that gravel trap? And that's a blown engine for Romain Grosjean. So having a difficult race anyway. And the gap between Raikkonen and Hülkenberg was only 8 tenths of a second as they went over the line. Hülkenberg in the pits now. So has he stopped before Raikkonen? I believe so. He's looking for the advantage of the undercut. 11.9 seconds. It is a long stop. Raikkonen's stop probably won't take that long. But can Hülkenberg jump him on the second round of pit stops? Looks eminently possible. As Piquet pits from 7th. Hülkenberg rejoins sixth. There's a bit of clear track, but he's got Kobayashi ahead of him, not too far ahead. Meanwhile, the rest of the top eight, Robert Kubica's moved up into seventh, so that's a good effort from him, considering that he started down in 18th. Piquet was in 8th position then. So it's been not a bad race for him either. And a good stop from Buemi. That was only 11 seconds. Hamilton pits. And it's been fairly unspectacular drive for him, despite being shunted off at the beginning by Kobayashi. And then that, and Buemi just rejoined ahead of Hülkenberg for third position. Duo Rouge, whoa, don't do that, your teammates. If these two start battling, this could help Raikkonen a lot. Vettel has dropped a bit behind Raikkonen now, 5 seconds. Hamilton's safe in fifth place, it seems. As it stands, having with Alonso having gone off track, looks as if it will help his championship cause a lot. This is Kimi Raikkonen going around Stavelo. Due a pit stop, I would assume. You fly into the pit lane from the bus stop chicane. Vettel only 4.7, so he clawed back a bit of time on the Finn. And there's a car pulled off on the right. I'm not sure who that is. Into the pits comes Raikkonen. And Hülkenberg has gone off the track and he's shunted into the barrier. Oh, dearie me. That will move Hamilton up to fourth position. But just a straight up driving error from Hülkenberg. When a win looked possible. Raikkonen and Vettel in. We saw Raikkonen diving into the pits. So can Raikkonen rejoin ahead of Buemi? It was a slightly longer stop, by which I mean only a tenth. Where is he in terms between himself and Buemi? Going around Lesource. And out of the pit lane. I think he's still in the lead. Raikkonen is still in the lead, but Buemi's right behind him. Buemi's got a chance into Lacombe. Let's see as they go through Eau Rouge. He's in the slipstream. Now let's see what is going to happen here. Raikkonen taking the middle, he's moved to the outside now. Buemi's going to outbreak him. And he does so. Buemi takes the lead on lap 32. There is an Andy Racing in front. No, it's a GRM in front. Now Buemi is in the lead, but Raikkonen is on fresher tyres. So we are going to see a battle between these two. Vettel looks as if he's a bit too far back. Can at least hold on to third position. He's a fair bit ahead of Hamilton. Would estimate around 12 seconds. And Buemi's in! Electrical problem! Well, that's just sheer bad luck. That's virtually gifted the race to Raikkonen. Can he rejoin ahead of Hamilton? I don't think he can. But he will be on good tyres. 8.2 seconds, it was just a tyre stop. Now that was unlucky, that. It looked as if we were going to see a good battle between Buemi and Raikkonen. And there was Hamilton. Buemi does still have a chance of the podium. Rejoined in between Hamilton and Kobayashi. Kobayashi's had a great race, he's only 20 seconds behind Raikkonen in that Pedersen. So good effort from him. And Raikkonen is being caught by Vettel. His gap's only 2.9 seconds as they went over the line with 7 laps to go. It's not all over yet. Neither is this battle for third position. And Jarno Trulli's moved up to 8th position as a result of the retirement from Hülkenberg. So it's been a good recovery from him. And Buemi on his fresher tyres, getting very close to Hamilton now. There's a GRM that's needing to be lapped. And and he's doing a very good job of being a mobile chicane. And up the inside and poo on, that's a brave one. I wouldn't try it there again. Into the Fania chicane. Not close enough on that occasion. His next shot surely will be the bus stop. Go around Stavolo, and that's a good run, right up behind his gearbox now. And up the inside already, is he going to back out? No, he's not. That is third position for Buemi, that's the first part of Blanchimont, and Vettel is catching, just 0.3 of a second taken out then. Needs just a little bit more. At this rate, there won't be enough laps. And indeed there isn't. So this is the last lap and Raikkonen is 2 seconds ahead of Vettel. He has, let's be honest, had a storming drive in that Shannon. Maybe a few more laps and Buemi would have caught up. Because he is only 12 seconds behind. No doubt he'll have had the fastest lap. So the left and the right, right and the left, and then just the left kink to go. Kimi Raikkonen wins at Spa. His first win of the season, and Tornado's fourth. So that'll move him ahead of Hülkenberg in the championship, so he's up to fourth there. So just to confirm the results, Raikkonen won from Vettel and Buemi. Hamilton took fourth position. So he does extend his lead over Alonso, who finished down in 10th. Kobayashi, a great drive from him to be 5th. Piquet, Kubica and Trulli completing the top 8. Good drive from Kubica from 18th on the grid. Other finishers, Jenson Button missed out on the points. Quite a lonely drive to 9th position. And the championship, Hamilton 25 ahead of Alonso now. And Buemi just 6 behind Fernando, so he's getting ever closer. As mentioned, Raikkonen moves up to 4th, ahead of Hülkenberg in 5th. What does that do for the Constructors' Championship? That would be quite interesting. Meanwhile, Sebastian Vettel has moved up to 7th with that 2nd position, so very good result from him. Now, what does that do for the Constructors? Tornado only 3 points ahead of Schakenberg now. In fact, they were behind coming into that race, so they've now taken the Constructors' lead. Mitchell on 88 points, they're still in it. FJR 4th, being caught up a bit by Gear Racing. And Shannon moves up ahead of LeBlanc. LeBlanc slips down to 10th. Nevertheless, I still maintain they've had a good debut season. We'll see you for the next race at Monza.